Let's delete, create, and constrain while learning object fundamentals. What's up? I'm Jonathan, and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about covering objects in a little bit more detail. Now that you understand what mesh is and what it's made of, it's time to understand what an object is, and more specifically, how to create them, how to delete them, and a little bit more about the 3D space around them. Once again, starting with a fresh Blender file, let's go ahead and understand objects in a little more detail. So first of all, within the Blender community, we always know to delete the default cube and replace it with our own. So let's click the default cube and hit delete. If you want, let's undo that, and I'll show you another way of doing this, which is using X, which opens up the delete menu. And this X menu, we're going to be using it a lot more in edit mode, but I just want to introduce it to you here. So this is also another way of doing deleting. So while we're at it, let's also delete everything else in the scene, which is our light and camera. And then with that all deleted, we're left with an empty scene with this strange thing in the middle. Now, let's go ahead and explore this a little bit more. This thing will not get bigger or smaller when you scroll in, but it's something very important within the Blender workflow. This is the 3D cursor. Now, the 3D cursor, it's like your mouse, except within three-dimensional space. And if you open up the tool menu, you will see that in our view, the 3D cursor has its own location properties. So we could, in fact, move it using these values right here. To bring it back to the world origin, you can do Shift S for its snap menu, and let's go cursor to world origin. Now, another way of moving the 3D cursor is holding down Shift and then right-clicking and holding down the right-click to drag it about when it snaps to your mouse. So let's bring the 3D cursor back to the world origin. And the reason why I want to mention the 3D cursor is one of the very important things that the 3D cursor does, it is the origin of creation within Blender. Now, I very specifically said origin because we're about to cover that in a moment. So to create something in Blender, we can open up the creation menu, or within Blender, it's called the add menu. To do this, we're going to go Shift A. And then from here, we're going to go to mesh and cube and put in our own cube. Now, in many operations in Blender, when you do them, they bring up this little extra options menu on the bottom left. So if you click this, you can change some values before you click anywhere else, because this is the only time you'll be able to do it. So let's change this to 2.1, because this is very much our own default cube. So now let's close that and let's click away. And there we have. That's how we go ahead and create something. Now, an interesting concept of the 3D cursor is that if you were to go shift right click on a surface, it's going to snap to the surface of that three-dimensional object. Now, keep in mind that if you were to go ahead and shift right click and then drag away from it, you're actually moving it away from the object. So it's very much a shift right click, don't move it anymore. And with that there, we've just moved the origin of creation. Now, I've just said it again, the origin of creation. The reason why I say that is you might have noticed this little orange dot. This here is the origin of the object. So this object, which consists of the mesh of this cube, has this origin point that controls all the mesh. So now if we were to create another object, so let's go ahead and do Shift A, and let's create a UV sphere this time. Its origin is created at the origin of the creation point of the 3D cursor. Now let's go ahead into the menu here and let's just make it a little bit smaller. All right, so now with that done, I just mentioned snapping, and snapping is quite fundamental when it comes to CAD modeling and precision modeling. So we now know that the 3D cursor snaps to faces, but can it snap to other things? To do that, what we're going to do is, this here is the snapping menu. Yes, this is a little bit long-winded, but I need to show you this before I show you a much quicker way of doing things. Here you're going to see a whole bunch of snapping options. Let's go ahead and select vertex, because we're wanting this to snap to the vertex. Ignore all this down here, because half of it, I find, that doesn't really work. So now let's go ahead and snap our 3D cursor to this vertex here. You would think that it's shift, right click, and then drag it over it. Close. We have to activate our snapping by holding down control, and then when we get close to a vertex, it's going to snap to it. So now let's go ahead, let's snap to that vertex, let go of right click, and now we can create a new cube where its origin point will be right where that 3D cursor is currently. And there we have it. The origin of this cube is on the vertex of the other cube. All right, now let's just play around. Let's create a couple more things. So let's go and snap on this point here. Let's create a cone, and then let's snap to the vertex up here, and let's create a torus. Fantastic. Okay, now we have a whole bunch of mess in our scene, and I very much want to just clean it all up. We can see that we have a whole bunch of objects in our hierarchy. So let's go ahead and let's select what we want to keep. I want to keep this one cube. And now, do you remember how to invert what we've just selected? That would be Control-I. So with our selection inverted, let's go ahead and delete everything. So let's go X and delete, and there we have it, all cleared up. Now let's clean up the scene a bit. Let's go ahead and put this 3D cursor back in its point. Now, as I showed you, we can go Shift-S, and that moves it to the world origin. But there is also one other shortcut, which is Shift-C, which centered our scene, and that also centers the 3D cursor back onto the scene. So with that done, the last thing I want to show you is how to go about and duplicate an object. So let's select our object, and the simplest form of duplication is done using Shift-D. Now, the duplication's already been done and cannot be undone at this point. Now, if we move our mouse, you will see that we're moving out the duplicate. It's sort of constrained to our mouse. Now, if we want to cancel this movement, it's very easy. All we do is right click, and we have cancelled the duplication movement. But the duplication has already occurred. If you look in the hierarchy, we have two cubes that are coplanar. Now, coplanar means that they are infinitely in the exact same space as one another. I mentioned this word because it's going to come up a few times, because we can have some problems when objects are coplanar. So now that we have our duplicated cube selected, let's go ahead and delete it because it's going to create some problems for us. So let's go ahead and hit X and delete. Now, I also mentioned a constraint just now, so I want to go ahead and show you a little bit more about that. If we go Shift D, we're moving right this minute, but we're constrained to our mouse. I don't want to be constrained to our mouse. I want to go along our y-axis, which is this green line, or this red line, our x-axis, or maybe even the invisible line, which would be our z-axis. So to do this, it's actually very easy. Just go ahead and press Y, and you're now on the constrained to the y-axis. The same for the x-axis, and the same for the z-axis. Now, there is one other way of being constrained in this way, is using the middle mouse button, you can actually just drag out to which constraint you would like to go on. Now, lastly, speaking about constraints, there is an interesting way of constraining an object, which is called a plane constraint. And the way that's done is by shift-clicking the axis that you do not want to be constrained to. So with a shift Z, we are now constrained to the XY plane. Now, lastly, I want to say that when we're on a constraint, for instance, on the Y axis, because we've already constrained one direction, we can now put in a numerical input of what we're wanting. So I want this cube from its origin point to be 5 millimeters along the Y axis. All I have to do is type in 5. Now, before I type that in, just take a look. Up here on the top left, as I move my cube, these numbers are moving all over the place. Now, as soon as I hit 5, you will see that the cube is now snapped 5 millimeters along the y-axis of where it's constrained. Now, if I wanted it to be on the minus y-axis, it's as simple as typing in minus right now. And I can always undo that once again by hitting minus once again. And then to confirm this, I hit enter, and that there is how we go ahead and duplicate an item and move it a set distance using a numerical input. So, just a quick recap. We know how to delete things using X or delete, and then we also know how to duplicate things with Shift D. We know how to constrain it to our own axis and also to strange planes. For instance, this plane here is now the ZY axis. Now, on top of that, we also understand that the 3D cursor can be moved around and it is the origin of creation. We have our snap menu here that we can play around with. So let's go ahead and click an edge and snap it to this edge here. And now let's go Shift A to create a new object, such as a cylinder. So with that all recapped, the main point I want you to get from this is that there is an origin point to an object, not to the mesh. Great to see that you've made it through object fundamentals. Now you understand how to create objects, how to delete objects, and that objects have something called an origin point. Not only that, you now also know that Blender has two cursors, one of which is in the 3D space and is the origin of creation within Blender. Stick on till the end for a little something extra. Thank you so much to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome and it means the world to me. It's the reason why I can make videos like this. And if you're enjoying what I'm doing here and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord community down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue. For the awesome few of you that have made it to the end of this video, link down in the description is this small obstacle course to make sure that you really understand the concepts that we've just covered in this video, and it has a couple of little hidden extras from the last video too. As well as that, down in the description is also the solution video, so if you get stuck or you want to see if you've got everything right, it's down there too.